You can't feel the heat until you hold your hand over the flame. You have to cross the line just to remember where it lays. You won't know your worth now, son, until you take a hit. And you won't find the beat until you lose yourself in it.
What is going on, Mousetrap? Teslamouse here, being week 12 of the National Pokemon Association Season 2. And today, this week, and next week is do or die for us. Because we played like idiots last week and lost to A-Drive 5. Oh, we have to really redeem ourselves this week and at the very least next week as well. If we want any chance of making the playoffs guaranteed, otherwise, we'll have to resort to relying on the whole wild card slot. And that's not a sure thing for us. So today, we're going to take on GalacticElliot, who has a very, very, very scary roster. Let's go over his roster real quick. He is the Chicago Cubchoos. So his information will be in the movie description. His YouTube link, his Twitch, his Twitter, etc., etc. All that fun stuff will be in the description down below. Anyways, on his roster, he has Azelf, Mamoswine, Vaporeon, Medichan, Skuntank, Lantern, Mega Venusaur, Arcanine, Mismagius, Aerodactyl, and Licky Licky. The issue here is that he has a lot of good pivots, you know, to soak up weaknesses and whatnot. He has Lantern to soak up the electric weakness on his Vaporeon and Aerodactyl. He has Arcanine to possibly soak up the fire weakness on his Mamoswine and Mega Venusaur, although they resist with their thick fat abilities. And he has Vaporeon to soak up the water weakness for his Mamoswine and Arcanine. So there's lots of pivoting going on here. We do need to be on our guard, on our toes for this battle, because we cannot afford to lose this. We cannot afford to, guys. This is big. So, let's go to the moves, the Pokemon and the movesets I bring real quick. Then we'll challenge Mr. GalacticElliot to the battle. Actually, we'll add his friend code after because I forgot to do that. But let's quickly go over the Pokemon and moves. And let's display the bottom screen right now if I can find it. All right, we have Repo Man, the Scizor, or the Mega Scizor rather, with Bullet Punch. Now Bug Bite, not U-Turn anymore because Bug Bite boosted by Technician does more damage than U-Turn. And we have Super Power Iron for the Mamoswine. And we have Defog. This will be my Defogger of the battle. It's max speed, max attack, adamant nature, so we can hit very hard while having a Defog. Next up is Wash Gain the Roll Wash, physically defensive Roan to take care of that Aerodactyl and the Mamoswine. Moves are Volt Switch, Hydro Pump, Will-O-Wisp, and Pain Split. I kind of want to put Discharge or Thunderbolt on it to deal with the Vaporeon and not have to switch out on it. But I do want Volt Switch to pivot out of Mega Venusaur, so Volt Switch overall seems like the solid move there. That's the usual move I use on it anyways. Next up is going to be Rage Quit the Klefki. This is a Calm Mind set, like it brought against Person 715 and A-Drive. We have Draining Kiss and Flash Hint as a stab special attacks and Calm Mind to set up. But this time, instead of running Thunder Wave or Toxic, we have Magnet Rise. The reason why we have Magnet Rise is to deal with Earthquakes for Mamoswine and Aerodactyl, in case they carry those. Well, obviously Mamoswine will carry Earthquake, but it's possible Aerodactyl can as well. Next up we have Lord Raiden, the Thunderous Incarnate. This is a Nest, it's 9 Nest Plus slot, this is still my Prince set. Thunderbolt, Psychic, Grass Knot, and Thunder Wave. Thunder Wave to paralyze Aerodactyl, because it'll be obviously faster than Thunderous Incarnate. We have Grass Knot to hit Mamoswine and one-hit KO it, assuming it's not Sash. We have Psychic to deal massive damage to Venusaur. And we have Thunderbolt as a stab move. I probably should switch Volt Switch out. Switch out for Volt Switch. But I'm going to actually go Thunderbolt on Lord Raiden to deal with Vaporeon. It's equipped with the Life Orb. I actually should switch out. I'd rather have Expert Belt on it. So I'll switch that out in a minute. Next up we have Stardust the Latias. This is a new Latias set I'm bringing. The moves are Psychic as a stab to hit Mega Venusaur. Energy Ball to hit stuff like Lantern and Vaporeon, because God knows Grass Knot will do shit damage to both those Pokemon. Also hit Mamoswine. We have Reflect Type. Now this is an interesting move I decided to put on my Latias. What it does is basically it has Latias copy the typing of the opponent's Pokemon. So if I'm forced to go for a Mamoswine, I'll use Reflect Typing. It'll get the Ground and Ice typing, negating its Dragon and Psychic typing, and thus it will only be hit neutrally by ice type moves. Plus, Earthquake won't be able to hit it because of Levitate. So yeah, Reflect type will be good to dodge Sleep Powder from Mega Venusaur, be good to dodge Ice Beam from the likes of a Lantern and Vaporeon, be good to dodge super effective ice attacks from Mamoswine. I'm gonna hope that it works out. I had that instead of Defog this week, because I do think that Reflect type would be the better thing going on. The better decision all around. We also have it in case you bring Skuntank. So Skuntank will only hit us for not very effective damage. Granted, we can't really do much back except for Energy Ball. I hope that we get enough special defense draws to where we can actually finish it off. But we do have Reflect Type for those scenarios. And we have Recover, not Healing Wish. But we have Recover to heal back our HP from Life Orb Recoil and any other damage we might take. So here we go. And making the NPA debut for us this week is Bad Karma the Malamar with the move Psycho Cut. Superpower Rest and Sleep Talk. It is a careful nature, 252 HP, 252 special defense, and I believe either 4 attack or 4 defense. I'm thinking it's 4 defense. But we have Rest and Sleep Talk to heal off any status like burns, poisons, sleep. Well, not sleep, but burns, poisons, paralysis that Malamar may be inflicted while setting up by increasing its attack and defense of superpower every turn it hits it. Psycho Cut for stab damage on the Venusaur. The one thing that we are fearing, however, is U-turn from Azelf, but hopefully he won't bring that and we won't have to worry about. Granted, Vaporeon can carry Signal Beam, although I doubt that it will in this battle. Venusaur can carry Fury Cutter. I don't think anyone would run Fury Cutter on a Venusaur. That would be kind of weird. And I don't think a Skuntank gets any Bug-type moves, although maybe it can get Scissor. I don't know. But enough talking. I'm going to go ahead and add Mr. Elliot's FC. I kept him waiting long enough, so I'm going to go pause recording, and I'll be back in a jiffy. All right, Mousetrap, we are back, and we are signing online. We added Mr. Elliot. I do apologize to you, Elliot, for keeping you. Had to do my pre-recording stuff and whatnot, and I had to add you because I forgot to. But now it's 8 o'clock right now, pretty much on the dot, so we're starting right on schedule. So I'm going to go ahead and send in the bell. Got my trusty vanilla milkshake to calm me down because I'm a little bit nervous because this is do or die. But honestly, I am only have myself to blame for this one. But anyways, let's do this. It's time for some NPA redemption here. I mean, if I lose Elliot, I might have to really try for a 5 or 6-0 an exception next week to if I want to increase my chances of making the playoffs via wild card slot. But hopefully it won't resort to that. We're sending the bell. We're waiting for him to accept. I'm predicting him to bring out those six. I've been thinking of what combination of six he could be bringing. And I came up with a grouping that I'm quite comfortable with him possibly bringing. That'd be Mamoswine, Vaporeon, Mega Venusaur, Arcanine, Medicham, and Aerodactyl. He'll probably be running Defog on the Aerodactyl because I believe he did before. And so for Skuntank, there's really nothing else that can get rid of entry hazards. Although we're not bringing in entry hazards. If you guys noticed, throughout the NPA, we didn't really rely on bringing entry hazards at all. Except against Brady, but that's the only case that we brought entry hazards against. I don't know, for me in draft format, I don't like to rely on that. I'd rather just keep the entry hazards off my side of the field outright than worry about keeping them on theirs. So he's not accepting, but hopefully he will soon. I do believe he has been known to run Scarf Medichan, so yeah, that might be a very big problem for us. So hopefully we can do something about that. Arcanine can be taken care of with Room Watch, although I do know he brought Solar Beam Arcanine at one point to one of his NPA matches, so that's something I need to watch out for. Vaporeon is going to be a problem with its clericness, the ability to cleric up. And, Mamoswine, hopefully doesn't have Freeze Dry and or Smackdown, because that would be really awful for us. Passerby, can you fuck off? Thank you. Alright, so yeah, we're going to be predicting them to bring Mamoswine, Vaporeon, Mega Venusaur, Aerodactyl, Arcanine, and Medicham. Hopefully we can get this on, and hopefully we can make something happen. I mean, yeah, hopefully we can do something. And I'm going to send in the bell once more. I don't know if he's ready or not, but I did tell him I was sending the bell when I'm ready, so I'm going to send him once more. Maybe he didn't get the challenge, because sometimes that does happen. Oh, I'm so nervous. So nervous. All right. So chill out here. I wonder if he's as nervous as I am. He has nothing to lose. I have everything to lose in this. I mean, he has everything to gain and nothing to lose. I have stuff to lose here, like my spot in the playoffs, so. He's not accepting, so I guess I'm going to pause recording, and I'll be back when the battle's actually on, so. Be right back. Alright, and this match is on. Let's see how much of my predictions I got right. I'm kind of nervous here. Let's go to music number 21, ZNS theme for some hype music, and good luck, Elliot. Have fun. Let's do this. Oh, God. This is do or die for us. How much did I get right? We got... How much right? Where's my pen? I need my pen to write down this team or something. Oh, there it is. A little nervous here. A little nervous. But yeah, I'm predicting him to bring Meloswine, Vaporeon, Mega Venusaur, Arcanine, Medchan, and Aerodactyl. So, here we go. This match is about to be on. Hopefully his internet cooperates. I don't know if his internet went out earlier or he just went offline to get a Pokemon or something, but hopefully we'll be good to go. Woo! A little nervous here. Do or die, guys. Do or die. We are back, and I got half of them right. He is bringing Arcanine, Venusaur, Mamoswine, Lantern, Skuntank, and Azelf. So I got half of them right. A little nervous here, but there's not much we can do. And I'm not really sure what I want to lead off with. I mean, I could lead off with the Thunderous Incarnate to paralyze his Azelf, I guess. But, yeah, I think that's what we'll do. I mean, he has a cleric and lantern, apostle cleric, so we're going to lead off with Lord Raiden here this time around. I mean, he might lead off with Mammoth. He's got like two rock setters, a Defogger and a Skuntank, so, yeah. Although, aside from himself, I don't think my Malamar's going to fear anything, so let's do this. This battle is on. Good luck, have fun, and let's do it. If you start, so if Mammoth can at least get a nice grass knot off and do a massive damage to his Mamoswine, that would be swell. And here we go. It's on. It's on, it's on, it's on. Please throw out the Mamoswine or a Zelf. I would really, really, really love that. I'd love you a lot for that, actually. So, he is going to lead off with his, after we send out our Lord Raiden here, Green Lantern. Okay, well, that's not really what I want to see, but, okay, that's not what I want to see him start out with. I suppose it could be a lot worse. Yeah, let's go to Stardust Latias. I can get a Reflect type off. So this is an awkward start. Lantern versus Thunderous Incarnate. Not the best of situations, but we're gonna hard switch our Thunderous out, going to Latias here. Worst case scenario, he goes for Ice Beam on the Thunderous Incarnate slash Lia, so we can we'll take a little bit of damage, but we won't get one hit KO'd, and then we can just go Reflect type, switch into an Electric slash Water type, and he won't be able to paralyze us. So let's hope that is the case here. So here comes Stardust. Come on, Stardust, you got this, right? So he goes for Volt Switch, unfortunately for us, which is not really great for us, sadly. Very awkward situation here. We could have went for a Psychic, but we wanted to do a safe thing in case we went for Ice Beam. I mean, I don't know how much sense that made, but I don't know. I don't know. But it's obviously not going to send a Mega Venusaur. It's going to send Skuntank probably with you know what? I'm okay with this. He wants us. Let's show off our new strats. Let's show off our new meta strats, guys, and go for Reflect type here. Hopefully it's not a Scarf Skuntank, because that'd be really bad. Let's go, Reflect type Latias. Copy that Poison Dark typing of it. This thing could have pursued on you. So we do become a poison slash dark type now. Pursuit? Yeah, not gonna happen, buddy. So let's just keep going for, I guess energy ball, since we have nothing else that we can really go for here. So I thought we'd switch out. Hopefully it switches out himself. Yeah, I am starting to regret not bringing something that hits Skuntank neutrally, like maybe Thunderbolt or Surf, or maybe even Hidden Power Ground, but I did need the Energy Ball for the Lantern and possibly the V-Porting, as well as the Mammoth Swine, so there's not much I could have done about it, to be honest. I mean, we could have hard switched out into Rotom Wash here after the Pursuit, but, you know, I want to see what he's going to do. So hopefully he'll switch out and go into his Mammoth Swine here and take a nice beefy energy ball to the face, because that would be marvelous and heartwarming and all that great stuff. Like, I don't know what I'm talking about here. I'm a little nervous. I'm like nervous here. So he's not a life orb, Skuntank. He's not life orb. He'll withdraw, so we need an energy ball of something. Hopefully the Mammoth Swine. Morgan, who's that? Arcanine, that is not wonderful for us. That is not fantastic. I'm not really sure what this Arcanine can do to us, though. But it's still not wonderful. Oh, ugh, this is not good. So he has Life Orb, though. What can Arcanine do to a Latias here? Let's go for Reflective again. Maybe we'll go for Will-O-Wisp or something. This is not a good situation to be in already. Yeah, so hopefully he does go for Will-O-Wisp or something. Snarl? Okay, so he's a special attacking Arcanine. That is good to know, I guess. We'll go for Psychic, I guess. He could switch out a Lantern and get a Scald off or something. Very interesting situation we got here. We're gonna go for Psychic with the Latias. It doesn't do too much damage. Please don't go for something. Snarl again. Well, I'm definitely not going to switch into something that Snarl will hit. This thing is actually making me really nervous, though. Let's go for Recover here, see what we got going on. The thing could have Solar Beam, too, I just realized. So, just Snarl Arcanine. We didn't get our special attack drop severely, though. That's the only thing here. Ugh. We can just keep doing damage, though, so. He's got Snarl. He's probably got E-Speed. He's probably got Morning Sun. We'll go for Psychic here. So they'll just switch. I'll probably go into Skuntank now. Take a Zelfie? No, dude, you take a Zelfie. I don't know why Zelf can do a fire type, so. This will go on a Rotom Wash. He'll probably set up rocks too. This is a bad situation. I mean. Self rock, yep. Okay. Very bad situation to be in right now. This thing probably has E-Ball too. Your turn? Alright. So I guess what's gonna happen here, he is Life Orb. So I'm probably going to Lantern. to eat this will-o-wisp, I'm guessing. Green Lantern, yep. And this will-o-wisp hit. I'll be right back. My parents are calling me, so I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. So we burned the lantern. That's all great and all. This thing probably is Heal Bell. I'm not really sure what else to do. Actually, they will put... I don't know, this is... You might go Revolt Switch, actually. We'll go for Hydro Pump. You might expect a switch here. We'll go for Hydro Pump. We miss, of course. That doesn't really matter. Oh, well, this is shit. The toxic. Well! This is shit. Yeah, I probably should put toxic on my room for this. But oh well. But the funny thing is, I was actually considering switching to Malamar. Yeah. You got no reliable recovery outside of leftovers, so we're fine here. Maybe we'll go for a Volt Switch or something. Yep, he'll go for Volt Switch. We'll see what he's going to bring out. This chip, this residual damage is not going to go well on our Rotom, so... 10 minutes and not one Pokemon is fainted. Feeling a little stressed out here. I was hoping to bring an Assault Vest Lantern, but of course he brought Toxic, so. RIP. Well, I do know that Azelf is not special based, it has a U-turn and not Energy Ball. Pretty sure I would have turned one energy ball there. Rotom Wash. Raise that Arcanine out, I'll just switch to Malamar. I'll switch to Bad Karma. That's what I'll do. I mean... this thing could be speed invested. It could speed creep my Rotom Wash and that would not be good. I don't think this is worth the risk here. Actually, you know what? Oh wait, Clucky can't sweep because of that Arcanine. Let's go to Malamar here. Let's go to Bad Karma. I know his Venusaurus can carry Hidden Power and Fire, so swapping onto Scizor would not be wise. So here's Bad Karma, the Malamar. Let's see what you got. Sleep Power? I don't think it would run Sleep Power on this, but... you know, what can I say? You see it? Oh god. This is a very bad situation. Well, you know what? It's not the worst situation. It's not the worst. We can win this. We've had worse situations in the past. We can definitely win this. We can definitely do this. We can definitely pull something off here. We can pull off a miracle. We're down, but we're not out. It's probably going to Azelf here. Morgan!
Ooh.
Are you intimidating? Please tell me. Yes. Yes, you are. So now we're at plus one. Well, we do get. Now we're at plus two in attack and plus one in defense. Now, what I want to do here is I kind of want to actually go for the Psycho Cut. I don't really want to go for any more superpowers if I can absolutely help it, but I will go for a Psycho Cut. If I did go for a Psycho Cut, I probably would have hit him, maybe in knocked him down to the red, but... See, might go for Will-O-Wisp here. Well, a plus two Psycho Cut do a lot of damage to a Zelf, is the question. Come on, bad karma! Give us some good karma and get us the win here. I am depending on you so hard right now. This is our debut. Do what Lunchables couldn't do and have a successful debut in this battle. I don't think he wants to risk a knockoff though. He knows that we could pack knockoff, and I don't think he wants to switch into a Zelf on that one. So a good play on his part, well, not really a good play, but the optimal play for him would probably be to sack off the Arcanine here. So we do know this Arcanine has Snarl, but we don't know its other three moves. Will-O-Wisp, that's fine, we can just rest it off, honestly. That's fine with me. We can rest it off. What is it? That puts it neutral. That does like nothing, holy crap. I thought we'd put us down in neutral health, but you know, we got rest. This is why we brought the rest talk set, guys. We brought the rest talk set specifically for this situation. So let's show him what our Melimar is made of, shall we? Let's show him. Let's show. Please don't switch out though. That'd be awful. That would be awful. Will-O-Wisp, Snarl, Morning Sun probably. Come on, Melimar, you got this. I should have went for rest initially, predicting the Will-O-Wisp, but I didn't. Could have got some sweet momentum there, but that wasn't too bad of a misplay. Lancer? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, here comes the rest. Now we have to go for sleep talk, so we got two turns of sleep talk to go for. We're back at our plus two, I believe. We're gonna get hurt by the leech life, but that's fine. It's all good. It's all Gucci. Let's hope we don't pull a rest off of our Melimar, so let's go for sleep talk here. You go for a roar or something? Come on, hit the cycle kill, let's go. Yeah! Yeah, he went for. So, Roar, Will-O-Wisp, thank you for getting rid of our, thank you for getting rid of our, Leech Seed, I guess. Let's go for a Psychic here. So we know he has Flamethrower, he has Roar, he has Snarl, so he's a special attack one, so actually setting up a Klefki would not be that big of an issue, to be honest. And then we can just go for Reflect type again. So Snarl, Will-O-Wisp, Roar, and Flamethrower. Elias is putting in some work here. I'm worried that this battle is going to come down to timer. And that's not a good thing, because I'm in a worse position. I got more damage on my team than he does on his. Alright, let's see. Take a Zelfie. Alright, so you go for your turn, that's fine. So it's left. You know what? I'm hoping he'll go for the, I'm hoping he'll switch into Mammoth Swine on my Clefki. That's what I'm really hoping for. And just reveal Magnet Rise and be all set. So he knows I don't want to keep Latias in on his Azel, so. Yeah. Really, really, really nervous. I can kill this Azel somehow. I'll be fine, because there's nothing else I can set up rocks except a Mammoth Swine. I'm assuming this Mammoth Swine is either Choice Banded or Assault Vested. So please go for the U-turn, I beg of you. I quad resist the U-turn, so. Shot ball, okay. They're gonna mix Azel. Oh shit! Okay, that's not good. Calm mind, I guess. Well, this actually, we can just keep letting Azel take him Life Orb Recoil. That's fine. So, just switching to, Mammoth Swine. Hey, he doesn't want to go for U-turn, because he doesn't want to take damage. He's gonna send in Green Lantern. Fine by me, you know what? You do that, you enjoy yourself. Probably expecting a T-Wave here. He might have a Revolt Switch for all I know. I want to say another Calm Mind is the way to go. This is do or die, guys. Yeah, okay, so he has T-Wave on that. That's awesome. That's not that bad. Oh, he has T-Wave. Lucky, lucky us. Lucky us, man. Lucky, lucky us. Let's go for Drainkiss. Watch this get RNG'd. This is like 20 minutes and not a single Pokemon spin. I really need something faint on this side. Because if time runs out and I have a 6 Pokemon to his 5, I win. But I cannot afford to lose any Pokemon at all. But I need this Pokemon to be in rougher shape than mine. But we have 3 status inflictions on our side, so that's not good. That is not good at all for us. That is not what we want to see. We have a Citrus Berry on a Klefki, so. Someone's gotta go down. Someone's gotta go down. He's gotta let the lantern, he's gotta let something go down. I'm gonna draw Green Lantern, let's see what he goes to. Arcanine maybe? Morgan Freeman the Arcanine? Please tell me we do not get fully paralyzed, that would be really awful for us. Of course we do, so. The RNG gods is trying to tell me I'm not going to make playoffs this year. He might have Roar, actually. This might be a 6-6. He's probably going for Roar. If he does, we're boned. Yeah, not in a good way. Like, very badly. Please go for a Flamethrower and not survive. He goes for Roar. I can't win. And the worst possible switch comes out. That is just awesome. I love it when that happens. That is just wonderful. That was the worst possible switch that could have occurred. My back's against the wall. Like, I can't get anything out. There's like 25 minutes left on the clock. My back is literally against the wall. This is a time where I start to feel depressed and whatnot about what's happening. And it's really not, it's not a great feeling. I really don't want to feel that way. I honestly do not. Snarl's not really going to help us, but, we got a special attack rage, if only we had a special attack. Well, let's go for sleep talk, I guess. Maybe we can get lucky with a Psycho Cut critical hit? Please hit Psycho Cut or something. That's two turns of sleep, so we hit rest. Well, we sent out Latias at least. There's that. That's a good thing. We get a nice recover off here. Hopefully, it's not close to a Snarl, because that'd be very awful. I mean, would the NPA count as 6-6 as technically a tie, even though the game says that I lost? That's something I can hope for. I doubt that is the case. But I'm really... Recover. Here comes a Snarl, maybe a Roar. Or something. Snarl's gonna hit us. What am I talking about? Show me with a Psychic. Will-O-Wisp? Suppose that's alright. So we got four sets to play the Pokemon. He has one. Unless I kill a Pokemon, we basically lose this battle. We basically lose this. Oh crap, I don't know what to do. My back's against the wall. My back is seriously against the wall here. I don't know what to do. I'm gonna go for the Psychic, I'll switch to the Skun Tank. I got nothing for this. I really don't. Bark up the Skun Tank. You know what? I'm gonna switch to the scissor here. Hoped and prayed to the almighty gods that... Alright, we lost the Pokemon. We lost. It's over. Keep calm, keep calm. Let's go for the fog here. Let's see. Alright, I can do this. I can win. I can do this. I can do this. Alright, so let's hope he goes for a, flamethrower or something. Snarl. Those are our special attack automatically. Now we have to. We're gonna actually go for a psychic here. Hopefully he'll switch into his Mammoth Swan here, predicting a Thunder Wave or something. Or his Lantern. That'd be great as well. That'd be the best situation. We got it. I gotta take something out. I can take something out, I believe. This is just a bad season for me, I think. But, well, I'm gonna keep faith. I'm gonna have a little bit of faith that we can, you know, that we can pull this off somehow. A miracle. Maybe we'll go for Roar, predicting a Nasty Pond. It's with the Morgan. He's going to, I believe, Mamoswine. Man, oh god! Oh god, please. Alright. I need him not to ice. Well, I need Ice Shard not to kill me. That's what I need. Okay, okay. Okay, okay, let's grass out. Let's take out this Mammoth Swine. Let's take out this grass. This Mammoth Swine. Let's go. I think we got an opening here. I think we got an opening. Assuming the Ice Shard does not kill. We got an opening. He went for grass out initially, but at the very. I didn't want him to switch into something like, Well, I think Psychic would have done more than Grasson and Lantern, so I just want to do some neutral damage at least. Okay, come on. Regroup. I don't want to be that guy though. If I get one of his Pokemon down, I'm going to not want to let anything else stand. I don't want to be that guy. I really don't. And I'm not going to be that guy. But please keep your Mammoth Swine. Please let the Grasson kill it. I am begging you. He is, scarfed. Oh. Does Grass not kill at this range? It does! Oh, we scored a KO. Okay, we killed the Mammoth Swine. That was a scarfed Mammoth, so. Whew! Okay, we might actually have this. So we got one down. We got one down. That's great for us. I'm glad he did not go for an ice type move. That would have been horrible. Alright. I think we got this. I think. We just gotta play a little game here. Called the stall game, which I don't want to do, but we gotta play a little game here. We're not gonna stall the timer, don't worry. Okay. Deep breaths. Thunderous, you got one down. Good. We got, now, I think instead of trying to take out his Pokemon, we need to keep ours alive. So that's what we're gonna try to do. So what would he switch out? Would he switch out into Sun? He's gonna switch out his Zelda. Actually, no. Go for a T-Wave here. I want to paralyze his elf so bad. Holy, he might switch a Lantern though, predicting that, but... I don't know, would he? He might want to get his rocks up, might be more worthwhile for him to do that. I don't know. What's Eladius' health even at, anyways? Alright, got Thunder Wave off, cool. He could take, you know what, if he wants to take us out, that's great. That's fine. Ooh, we do get him fully paralyzed, okay. We do get him fully paralyzed, so we're good. This is the times I wish we had Dark Pulse on our, Thunderous Incarnate. Let's go for Thunderbolt here. Oh, we got rid of this elf! Oh, we got rid of this elf. That was big. Melmar can go sweepy city if we can get rid of the Arcanine at least. That was big. Zelf. Of course, though, Elliot did kind of get a critical hit with the Thunderbolt, unfortunately for him. I do feel bad for that, but I do need this win. So I'll take the RNG. Because I think it's about time the RNG gods repay me for all their sins against me. All ye sins must be paid back in full. Right. So two are down on his side. Do I want to get... I don't know. You might go for Toxic, actually. Or you could go for Scald. Or go for Volt Switch. Well, this is at 6 HP, so what I want to do is actually, I don't know, you can go for either Toxic. You know what? I'm not done playing. I am not done I don't think we need Thunderous anymore after this. Maybe for the Venus. Well, we got Latias, so we can do something there, I suppose. We got Melamar. So we'll go for a Psychic here. See how much damage we can do this Lantern. Not too much. That's fine. He'll go for Volt Switch. We'll get Switch Initiative. That's okay. It'll kill? Yeah, it'll kill. Thunderous is down. That's okay. But whenever he switches in, we're going to be able to do something too. Alright, we need to keep our- alright, we need to stop playing around. We need to keep the rest of our Pokemon alive. What are you gonna switch in? What are you gonna switch in? Skunting? And he switches in the Arcanine. We switch in the Arcanine, I can just go on my Malamar. Go for Superpower. He'll probably roar me out. Expecting a setup. So he has Mega Venusaur. Alright, he has Morgan. Here we go. Unfortunately, they're back to full health. Not really what I want to see, but. Alright, Malamar, let's go. I might have to rest stall this Malamar though. There's 23 minutes left. I have one Pokemon over him. I don't want Malamar to faint. That is the only thing. Thanks, sir. Okay. Miller, I expect you to wake up. I guess we're gonna try and rest stall him or something. He has, actually, realistically, he has nothing that has Bug-type moves to deal with Malamar. And I don't want to do this for 20 straight minutes. This is gonna be boring as hell for you guys, for him, and myself if I do this. But what the hell else am I supposed to do, really? Little sleep talk here. What is the guy to do? I think Malamar is actually carrying this team. Come on, sleep talk. Do not go for rest. Well, you can, I guess. Go for superpower. Nice, 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 nice. Increasing attack and defense. That's cool. I don't think it has anything to deal with the Malamar, to be honest. I really don't. I don't think he does. Go for sleep talk again. Mantora, ooh, that's not good for you. Yuck. Come on, sleep talk. Super power again? Yep, I'll take it. We're at plus two, and a Psycho Kid, I believe, at plus two will take it out. We'll take this Arcanine out to dinner. Serve lunch to it on a side. With cannolis, I don't know. I do not regret drafting Malamar after all. I do not regret it. Because Malamar has actually become the MVP in this match. Oh, plus one, plus two Psycho Kit, let's go. Almost took you out, that's fine. Roar, you do it. You do you, buddy. You do you. Ooh, scissor though. Mmm. I don't think a Bullet Punch will take you off in that range. Hmm. No, we'll go for the Bullet Punch. We'll do as much damage as we possibly can to it. Which is nothing. I'm sure we'll knock it out, that's fine. And from that range, then we just go back to Malamar, go for rest. And start trying to set up again. This might have been a bad mistake on my part, but didn't really have any other options. Go for rest. Unless it crits me, it should be fine. Come on, Malamar, this is all you. This is all you. My hands are shaking right now. I don't want 90 minutes to run on the clock, though. I need to kill something else. Come on, do something. You got a low health Pokemon like Lantern and Arcanine. Lewis, there we go. There it is. I need something to happen here. I need a... Let's go sleep talk. The problem here is that we're gonna run out of superpowers. We can't really hit the Skunting. Go for Flamethrower. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Hit a super. I need to hit a Psycho Cut, actually. That's what I need to do. Can you do it? You can hit a Rest. That's cool, too. That is cool, I suppose. Not really, but you know. What do we got left? Nothing that can really save us, to be honest. Please stop hitting Rest. This battle depends on you. This battle honestly depends on you, Malamar. Like, literally. I'm not sure how we can win this. No, you know what? I just need to keep it alive. That's what I need to do. What I need to do is just keep this Malamar alive. Special attack increase doesn't really matter. Hit your superpower, I beg of you, please. Or a Psycho Cut. That works, too. Superpower, that works. Wake up and do your Psycho Cut. And take this Arcanine's head off. Off with his head! Off with this Arcanine's head! Of course not. Latias? Nope, burn. Nope, this actually works for us. I'll tell you why this works for us. Oh my god, 14 minutes left. I gotta do something here. Superpower. He knows it's pointless to go for, pointless to go for Willow, that's gonna just roar. We can just rest it off. Wait for Morgan. In comes Skuntick, I'm assuming. Buttercup. I hope you don't have a grass type, a bug type move, because that'll be really awful for us. This is the one thing that's actually saving me in this match. Malamar is going to be the win. If we win this battle, Malamar is going to be the one that wins it for us, straight up. I think, unfortunately for him, he might have to solve the timer, but hopefully he doesn't do that. I wasn't gonna do that. I could have done that, but I'm not that type of person. So there's like 12 minutes left. I need to get at least two Pokemon down. That's what I need to do. Mm-hmm. He's taking a long time to make his move. Toxic?
That works.
That works for me. He might have taunt on this. I'm pretty sure he's gonna run taunt, so. Do I even waste a turn going for rest? No, I don't. Buttercup, please let something die. God, please let something die. Green Lantern's dead. So Lantern is dead. I just need to go for toxic or rest here. My heart is pounding. I really gotta win this game. I mean, you could have. I think you might actually go for a switch into your Skunting, knowing that might go for Psych. Yep, called it. I knew you were gonna go for that. I knew it. I could have went for a superpower, but I didn't want to rack up any more toxic damage. Pursuit, not gonna switch out. Please hit a superpower, whatever you do. Malamar, hit that fucking superpower like you never hit a fucking superpower before. Let's go. Do it, Malamar. Do it like Charlotte Buff. Just do it. No, you hit a psycho fight instead. Of course you do. I needed you to hit that superpower. Watch, when you switch it into Venusaur, Fire Blast, okay. Alright, do it like Charlotte Buff, hit that superpower, let's go. Let's hit that superpower, they can sweep with Psycho Cut. Come on, come on, come on. Yes! Psycho Cuts are gonna finish the rest of his team off. Oh my god, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. Freaking Malamar is boss. Malamar is literally gonna win us this battle, this do or die battle. Unless some weird, crazy, out of this world critical hit happens. We got this. We have to have this. I hope I didn't just jinx myself, but goddamn Malamar, you are. I am proud of myself for bringing the rest talk set here. Could have brought an assault vest set, but that'd be bad because there's no way to recover HP. Either Venusaur is gonna come out or Arcanine is gonna come out, but either way, something's gonna take a Psycho Cut, and it's not gonna be pretty. Yeah, I know what you mean, Venusaur. This is gonna be like a plus four, a plus two Psycho Cut. This, no pun intended, may have been the sleeper Pokemon of the draft, guys. No pun intended. I'm getting a little too excited here. There's 6 minutes in the clock. We are specially defensive, so we should be able to take whatever this Venusaur has to dish out to us. Don't sleep on Malamar, guys. Don't sleep on Malamar. This battle could go the full 1 hour. That'd be the second time this week this happened. Except the other time was a stream battle, but still. I'm getting way too excited here. Oh, what do you got for us, Malamar? He had Fire Blast on that Skunting, so I'm glad he didn't put Scizor in front of that. Gear Drain? Yeah. Alright, I don't think there's anything. Oh my god, critical hit. Or not. Venusaur is down. Now, assuming this Arcanine doesn't kill us with a Flamethrower or something funky, we should be able to win this. With a... Okay. Maybe I should have went for rest there. I don't know. Hopefully did not. Hopefully that was not a million-dollar mistake for me. Please no crit. Please no crit. No crit. No crit. No crit. No crit. No crit, Flamethrower. Do your job, Malamar, and finish this Arcanine off. I'm a little nervous here. Little nervous. Don't kill, don't kill. Yes! Malamar! Thank you. That was a comeback that I can't even fathom, ladies and gentlemen. Like, and it looked like I was in a losing position because all those rocks and all those mispredicts. And I'm sorry, guys, if I'm acting like a goober, but holy shit. That was one hell of an epic comeback by Malamar. Malamar just. That was the right decision on my part. And I am extremely proud of myself for being Malamar. Malamar is all I can say, Malamar. My plan worked to have Malamar carry on the sweep with his superpowers and stuff. Granted, we did get roared out a few times. A few awkward things happened here and there, but overall, Malamar did pull through big time for us, and thank you, Bad Karma, for that. But please do not take anything away from GalacticElliot. He is a really good player, and a bit of trivia. He has beat me once prior to this battle, because I raided him once. He gave me an instant battle for his Mono Steel gem. He beat me, I believe, 1 or 2-0 there. So basically, we're 1-1 against each other, but we definitely pulled it through. Malamar was the MVP of this battle, straight up, no question about it. I don't recall how many kills it got, because it was in the heat of the moment, but when I took that breather, just like I recommend I should have done all along when I lose, and people tell me to take breathers and whatnot, I took the breather, and I got the job done, and that was just incredible. Like, I thought I lost. I really did, because at the beginning it was going so south for me. The turning point was getting rid of that Mamoswine Grass Knot and him not going for Icicle Crush. That was the one thing that defined the match right there, is when he went for the safer pull, well, the overprediction, and went for knockoff instead of Icicle Crush, and thus Thunderous Eye was able to KO the Mamoswine Grass Knot, and then we were able to KO the Azelf with the help of RNG, unfortunately, because Thunder Wave, and then it got fully paralyzed at one point, and then the Thunderbolt critical hitted it, and yeah. But guys, that was, leave a like, comment, subscribe to this channel if you want to see more league action. I'll have my NPBA match up later tonight, or, well, this will be uploaded Sunday, so it'll be later on Sunday night, because I don't know when we're going to get that bell done. But yeah, let me know what your favorite part of the match was, and go give Elliot a check out. I mean, he does shiny hunts, he does wonder trades, check out his Twitch, check out his YouTube. It'd be greatly appreciated. And guys, I'm going to hop offline. I need to go for a walk. I need to calm down, because that was nerve-wracking. But yeah, once again, leave a like, comment, subscribe if you want to see more. Check out Elliot's channel as well, and I'll catch you on the flip side. And remember, stay salty, Raichus. Stay salty. Also, when the chips seem down, don't give up, because you could pull off a win. Peace out, guys. Okay, thanks, bye. Whoop, whoop.